Hurricane Harvey made landfall in Texas on August 25, 2017, as a Category 4 hurricane with 130-mile-per-hour winds, heavy rains, and a massive storm surge. The storm stalled over Houston, Texas for days, dumping 50 inches of rain and leaving behind a path of destruction. At Lakeside Country Club, many wondered what would be left of the golf course after the storm.
It was like the rain lasted about 4 to 5 days before the sun came out. But it was just downpour after downpour. Everybody's kind of wondering if there was going to be anything left.
My initial reactions as I was watching it on TV was in complete shock. My reactions were, are we even going to have a club?
The flooding at Lakeside Country Club was worsened by the surrounding Buffalo Bayou and overflowing Barker Reservoir, a flood control structure connected to the bayou.
Once it gets to a certain point, our golf course becomes a retention area. And then Barker Reservoir was actually going over some places, so they had to release water because they were afraid the dam might break.
Determined to assess the damage to the facility, Golf Course Superintendent Terry Hutcherson sought the help of local authorities so he could climb a fence to enter the property.
So we jumped fences to walk in that day. We walked into our shop area, and it was the only thing that wasn't underwater. But when I walked out on the golf course, it was devastating. Pictures didn't do it any justice. You had to be here to see all the water. It's just, you look at your golf course and it was a lake. Yeah, you couldn't see much grass anywhere. This is about 7 to 10 days after the flood. These buildings here were completely submerged. So it's actually, the water's already dropped about 6 or 7 feet. There's probably 4 foot of water over 9 fairway. It's 9 green is right in there. Oh. So this cart path goes across underneath there. It was probably, I'd say there's 12 to 15 foot of water over the cart path.
The golf course was completely underwater, but fortunately the maintenance facility and equipment was safe from the flood, which was good news for Terry as he started to form a plan to save the golf course, even though plenty of hurdles still stood in his way.
I called some of my crew that could come out here. Most of my crew couldn't come out here. Some, they lost their houses too.
Working with minimal fuel and a crew of 5, one-fifth of his normal staff, Terry and his team got to work. In addition to the flooding, 44 trees had fallen, and damage to some buildings was yet to be assessed. But Terry's first priority was shocking to some.
I'm more worried about watering than I am about the water that's on the golf course right now. And they just went crazy. They didn't know what I was talking about. Like, why do you need water? The greens was my biggest concern. Everything else was secondary. And then thinking when I got out here, no power, no pump station, no satellites, no way to water. Well, that came to my second concern. How are we going to water this golf course? And so once these greens got into the sun and the debris and stuff that was on top of them, you know, the sun just baked them with just baking stuff on top of them. And they were just like walking on concrete. To save the greens, I've got to get water on. And that's something a lot of people didn't understand. But it's, you know, these greens are made for water to go through them, not stand on them.
Terry knew that when the water receded, he would need to work quickly to clean the surface of the greens so that he could begin to apply water. However, the severe flooding had deposited large amounts of silt on the putting greens.
It was silt everywhere you looked. It was probably anywhere from a half inch to 2 inches in places.
Terry and his team worked tirelessly to repair the golf course. But in everyone's mind, the best case scenario was looking like it would be well into the following year before golf could be played again. But Terry was able to surpass even his own expectations and open a portion of the course for play in just 16 days.
I was gonna be surprised if we played golf that year. That was my first guess. But actually, the par 3, which is you come in my gate, we opened it up in 16 days. And then the front 9, we opened up in 33 days. And then the entire golf course, we opened up in 43 days. You know, once we opened up the golf course, carts were restricted to car paths. There was no golf carts. Not even my people got off the car paths. We raised heights on the greens just a little bit to kind of cushion them just a little bit more. Once we got the greens open, we saw it time with many times every 5 to 7 days. opened them up and left them open. And you know, with the little pencil tines, you could do that and mow them the next day. You could barely tell that you actually aerified.
The golf course was reopened, but many restrictions were in place to assure the grass would recover properly. However, despite being open, the clubhouse and many other buildings around the facility were completely destroyed.
We had actually 4 feet of water get into the clubhouse, and that was devastating. We knew it was going to take months before we could get the facilities back open and running, but if we could get the golf course open where they could at least come and play golf, bring that sense of community back for the families and for the members. There had been so much, you know, heartache and disruption in the community. Even several of our members had homes that were flooded. It was good to be able to get them here to the property and let them enjoy their day and play some golf. So that was important to us.
A year later, the golf course is still recovering, but for the first time ever, it was closed for a full week so that Terry and his maintenance team could continue their work.
We did everything we could, but when the power is out for a couple of weeks at a time and the water's at 4 feet in your facility, you know, you reach a point where your preventative maintenance emergency plan is out the window. So, but still, you need to have one and understand the potential dangers that are in your area.
Full recovery from this storm for Lakeside Country Club will take years, including a planned rebuild of most of the golf course a few years away. But thanks to the amazing work of Craig, Terry, and the entire team, they have a future to look forward to.